Here, depending on the document you're writing, you're likely to have text that's repeated in many places in the document. For instance, you might have an invoice and you might have your address information repeated in two or three different places. Or you might be writing a report or email and want to include your manager's name in different places in the document. In some cases, you might even have some custom formatting for text. For instance, say you're writing a user manual and you want the reader to be aware of critical information that requires special attention. You might want to include that information with some special formatting or even in a text box. If you do any of these things, then I have some good news for you. Microsoft Word provides you with a bunch of features to automate the entry of items such as these. These text blocks can be edited once and repeated in different places in the same document. In this video, let's look at how to set up your document so that entering such information becomes quick and easy. Note that the method to set this up varies slightly depending on the type of text you want to enter. In this video, I won't cover how to include things such as automatic page numbering, which uses the concept of fields. Alright, the first category is text that's going to get repeated in different places in your document, but the text itself does not change. For instance, you might have the same greeting or signature repeated in the document, or you might want to include your address information in different places. MS Word calls this auto text. The most common way to enter such text is to write the text that will be repeated, click on Insert, Quick Parts, and choose Auto Text, then choose Save Selection to Auto Text Gallery to save your selection. Alternatively, in the Quick Parts menu itself, choose Save Selection to Quick Part Gallery. After you have saved your selection, you can enter it any place in your document by going to the location, clicking Insert Quick Parts, and choosing the entry. To make this process quick, you can even right-click an entry and choose to add it to your Quick Access toolbar. It then becomes available above or below your main menu, and you can quickly click it to add the entry you want. The second category is common document items that will be repeated, but that may change, such as your manager name or name. Instead of adding these items to auto text in the Quick Parts menu, choose Document Property. Then choose the closest property name, for instance, Manager. After this, go to the different locations in the document where you want to add the same property or text and insert the property in those locations as well. Let's insert one here. Now, when you click to edit any one of the instances of this property, you'll note that all of the instances change. You can also use this method to include information about things such as part names if you're a company selling parts. This way, the part names will remain consistent no matter where in the document they are referenced. The third category is text that includes some formatting that should be repeated, such as text boxes for important information or notes. For this, in the Quick Parts menu, go to Building Blocks Organizer. Here, you'll see a bunch of building blocks, including different shapes such as lines. You'll also see items such as text boxes for, say, quotes, in case your document includes them. If you want to make changes, you can make them. If you want to store paragraph formatting, click the option to show or hide the formatting marks, and then include that symbol in your selection before saving. For this option to work well, you might also need to choose the option Insert Content in its own page. But I have found that the best way to use this option is as follows. Go ahead and create your own style including a text box. For instance, let's create a text box manually. Let's add some text and change its formatting. For instance, let's change the background color of the text box. Let's add an outline. Let's also change the font color. Let's then save this as a building block. Now, you can go to any place in your document and insert this quick part item that you had saved. How cool is that? You can use this method to include notes that require attention and information from the reader. So this is how you can use MS Word to automate the entry of text and formatting in your document. The idea is not to automate as much, but to ensure that you save some time and at the same time ensure that common categories of text and formatting appear consistent throughout your document. I encourage you to check out my playlist of MS Word videos on this channel. If you have any questions or comments about anything in this video, do let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you for watching.